Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology is one of the leading Kenyan public universities. With a growing demand for education, JKUAT endeavors to maintain the highest level of excellence and increase the diversity of its academic programs.
There are four deputy vice chancellors supporting the vice chancellor who is the CEO. Today, we have the honor to host the DVC who is in charge of academic affairs. That degree, that diploma you want to earn at the end of your course will be awarded from the academic division. So it's now my pleasure to invite Professor Odhiambo.
Thank you very much, OMC, the Acting Registrar Academic, Mr. Kamau, my fellow Deputy Vice Chancellors in absentia, hope they are coming, the principals of the colleges and campuses, the deans, directors of the faculties, campuses and institutes, the registrars, chairpersons of the departments, our new students, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. Good morning, students. Good morning. It gives me great pleasure to welcome you, our new students, to Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology. My name is Romanus Odhiambo Otieno, the Deputy Vice Chancellor of Academic Affairs, the Division of Academic Affairs, where you actually belong. And I'm very happy that you have come, you accepted our invitation, and you are now part and parcel of the Jomo Kenyatta family. Unlike your past experiences, at the university, you'll be given guidelines by your lecturers and left to supplement them through individual reading. The university library is adequately stocked, from which you can borrow books and other printed materials. You can also access multiplicity of electronic books and electronic journals which the university subscribes to. We do, ladies and gentlemen, provide over 100,000 titles electronically through our subscriptions. Even where you are seated there, where we are right now, it's a library. So if there's no space in the library, you can access the reading materials where you are seated in the pavilion here, and you'll start realizing that very soon. The library has finally automated its services. The library staff will help you access and use both electronic and hard resources. The resources that we have are fully automated. For instance, you are required to register as a library user online using your smartphones. So you don't go to the library to register. Use your smartphones, computers, tablets, iPads, etc. So you register yourself, and now that you have a registration number of the university, you can actually access this. The catalog of the physical and electronic books is available in the library website. Library rules and regulations are also available online through the library website. I urge you to make best use of library resources.
I now call upon the university librarian to tell you a few words, Dr. Mangira.
Thank you so much, DBCAM, Professor Romanus Odhiambo, Principal Corpus College, Pure and Applied Sciences, Professor David Mulate, Director Adiso, Professor Waria Karioke, Professor Chairman COD Mining, Professor Rogue, Director Dakta, Dr. George Orwa, all protocols of SAB. Good morning. Yeah, it actually gives me pleasure once again, ladies and gentlemen, to say briefly something about the students, because DBC, we were able to address the students yesterday. And therefore, these students, maybe some were not there, but I want to say that I wish to congratulate you students for having met Jomo Kenyatta University, a university of global excellence in teaching, learning, research, and innovation. A unique university of quality and reputation. And therefore, you count yourself blessed to be in this university. I think, and by extension, to welcome you to the library. For those who were not there yesterday, we are giving a very warm welcome to the library. Library is critical for you. It's the heart of academic institution. You are in an academic institution, and therefore you have no choice, but you must make use and full use of the library resources, because library is a custodian of knowledge. You came here because of seeking for knowledge. If it was not for knowledge, you could not be here. And therefore, you will find all that you need from there. For us as a library, we can equip you with a lifelong learning. We've come up with a policy and a curriculum, in fact, chaired by our Deputy Vice Chair. It's already approved, it's a Senate approved, and chaired by my professor, Professor Wariara, a sub-Senate committee. I really thank you so much. I really take this opportunity because you gave us the opportunity to come up with this program, which is a critical program required by Commission for University Education. We forgot that library requires, has got a special needs section. For those who were there yesterday, I forgot to talk about it. So in case you are here and you have kind of special needs, impairment, hearing, and partial, or physically challenged, we have a section, please come. Then we as the library, we like to work with you very closely. We partner with you. You are so many. You are 11, maybe 10,000. Librarians are less than 50. So for us to make our work easier, we have come up with something called library ambassadors. And these library ambassadors should come from you. You come to the library, we will equip you with the skills, and you run with that thing to help us market the library, talk to your colleagues and all that. So if you have the skill of marketing, please come and see us, and then we register you, we empower you. At the time, you will be through and you will have done what you have given you to do. We can also do an acknowledgement letter to say that you partnered with us and it adds up to your CV. So please think about it. The last thing that I want to say, Professor, while I was seated here, Professor Rob showed me a particular book and he told me that he is donating that book to the library. So I said, please stand up, allow us to welcome him to do it officially, kindly.
Bwana Yesu asifiwe. Praise the Lord. Amen. This book, okay, plus other books. I'm a professor of petroleum engineering geology. I've also written other books on oil and cars, the one we have discovered even in Kenya. The person whom God used to unravel and discover where the oil is currently being drilled is this humble young man called Professor Rock. You can Google and check in the internet. But then I want to officially, you heard me talking about so many scriptures and all that, I wrote a book this year called From Glory to Glory. And that is also relevant to you because last year was a different glory. This year, you have come to this auspicious university and therefore I will expect you now to move from one glory to another. You will read, I'm donating three of these books to the librarian. And I want to ask the DVC to officially acknowledge it, and then I will take the three books to the library.
Thank you very much, Professor Rob, for this great donation of the book From Glory to Glory, that you will always fly, that you reach here, you are always on top, and I think it's a great read for you guys. Take time to read it. And may God bless you. Thank you very much. I can now hand it over to the librarian.
So otherwise, may Almighty God bless each one of you. The only thing I want to say that before you have been talked to, you did not have enough knowledge. Now you have acquired so much information, and as I said yesterday, I believe in the power of information. I like quoting Hosea 4:6 that says, my people perish for lack of knowledge. It is my guide. Make it your guide too. So many things that you didn't know, now you know, and may God bless you.
Ladies and gentlemen, course led by our chief guest this afternoon, the Vice Chancellor. Good afternoon. Madam VC, I did address our new students who I promoted this morning to be ladies and gentlemen. And I told them what academic division is all about, what our expectations about them is all about. And one of the things I told them that in the history of universities, the Vice Chancellor only addresses students, the ladies and gentlemen like the ones in front of us this afternoon, only two times in their lifetime in the university. And this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, we have the Vice Chancellor who is coming to address you the first time. That is the person I want us to put our hands together as we welcome her to address us, Professor Mabel Imbuga. Thank you very much.
The Deputy Vice Chancellors, Campus Principals, Deans of Faculties, Schools, Dean of Students, Directors of Institutes, Chairpersons of Departments, the student DECUSA leadership, starting with the president. You know, they introduced that name recently. Yeah. So we have now two presidents in Kenya, one of them being Anyango. Yeah. Yes, so DECUSA and all protocols have served, new students. Good afternoon. I want to thank the DVC Academic Affairs. I'm really delighted this afternoon to join the entire university fraternity to welcome all the new students to Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology. In fact, nowadays we are saying the Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology, because there's no other JKU at this, the one and only one. And first of all, I start by congratulating you all for choosing this great institution of higher learning, even when you had options to join other universities. We have nearly 74 universities now in Kenya. That is something public and that is something private. So we really appreciate you having chosen JKUAT, and we can tell you, you didn't make a mistake. You'll be proud of yourselves once you graduate. Your choice of JKUAT is a demonstration of overwhelming confidence you and your supporters have in our institution. We are very proud of you in this regard. On my behalf and that of the entire university community, I warmly welcome you to Jomo Kenyatta, to the Jomo Kenyatta University of Agriculture and Technology. You will be able to access the e-books and e-journals and other academic materials from the library. Overall, you will learn from virtually everywhere at any time. Learning needs to be enjoyable and exciting exercise. And we have put around some hot spots that you can also use to access the network. And even as you are accessing the network, don't veer too much from academics. Whatever you set out to do, pray to God first and to grant you good health and wisdom. So always put God first in whatever you do. Once again, allow me to congratulate you for excelling in your Kenya Certificate of Secondary Examinations and making it to this university of your top priority. This is the university of choice, the university of top priority. And as I said, we have the best academic staff, we have the best technicians, we have the best non-academic staff, and they really make use of this opportunity that you have been given. I wish you all the best in your academic endeavors and a bright future. Thank you for your attention. God will bless you all. And let us continue to propel the good name of JKUAT forward. Thank you and God bless.
I'm Dr. Roslyn Mangina, University Librarian, JKUAT. And on my right is Deputy University Librarian, Instructional and Information Services. On my left is our Deputy University Librarian, Administration and Bibliographic Services. We wish to take this opportunity to welcome our first year students who have joined Jomo Kenyatta to come to the library and make use of the library resources. I know that this is an orientation week, and I'm going to request our two deputies to coordinate a team that is going to take all the students round through the physical library, which has got several sections, I think around 11 of them, and they will be working together with the heads of those sections. So, and I expect them also to introduce to first year students about the virtual library, which is the most rich, resourceful library, since it has got so many volumes of electronic journals and electronic books. So you are most welcome to the library.
I am Mercy Wanjiru Mathenge, and thank you, our academic secretary, for coming and telling us more about the JKUAT library. So what's your general view concerning the JKUAT library?
My name is Clement Chuyot, the academic secretary of JKUAT. And my view about the library is, our library is among the best in Kenya, if not in Eastern Central Africa. And this is because we are well endowed with the resources, the books, the e-resources, and we are majorly invested in the e-journals and the resources that we can get in the cloud as students. Our university library may not be big enough in terms of infrastructure, but students do not need the infrastructure anymore because we can access the books via our laptops in the comfort of our phones. And not only do we have the best resources, we also have the best personnel in the library, starting from our chief librarian. She is among the most experienced librarians in Kenya, and that alone brings quality to learning and to reading in the library. And I think that is why we get most graduates from JKUAT out of quality.
Okay, so what you're trying to tell us is that JKUAT library is well equipped, making so many students, okay, it's among the universities that is ranked for providing or giving the country's better students. So what's your view on that?
Our library, the resources from our library can be easily accessed from the comfort of one's phone, from the laptop. We have Wi-Fi hotspots in the school. People do not have to go to the library physically to go and study and get the materials there. People can just subscribe to the e-resources. They get notified of the new books and everything, and that is how they can easily access the information they need from the library.
Okay, currently there are freshers, commonly referred to as freshers, but first years are in school. So what's your advice?
I'm advising the first years in school to subscribe to the university e-resources, to the library, because that is the first place you should make our library our first homes, because we've come to JKUAT to study, and that is the main core thing that we are supposed to do in school. Library is what will make us achieve the goal of studies, and to get the first classes we have to just shade off every other thing and make our library the best friend.
Thank you, Clement, for coming. We really appreciate the knowledge you've shared to us concerning our library.
Ladies and gentlemen, ladies and gentlemen. So I want to take this opportunity to welcome you to the library and to JKUAT once again. I know you have been doing a lot of movement around the university. But when you have not come to the library, then you have not entered to the world of academia. This is the heart of the university. So today, this afternoon, is a very important occasion for you, because we are going to take you to give you a tour of the library.
Good morning. Good afternoon. Thank you so much for being so much alert. My name, as I have been told, is Caroline Kibuna. I'm the Deputy University Librarian, Instruction and Information Services. And this orientation program is very vital for us because that's the beginning of your career of 4, 5, I don't think we have 6 years, isn't it? So please make sure you have a notebook in your hand. Every information, make sure you note it down. Make library, and I repeat again, make library your friend of choice. Talk you briefly about the terrorism. In case of a terrorist come around, first you have to be vigilant, just to know who is seated to you, what is this next to me, alert the security people. And in case it happens, you hear that shot, if you hear it, know that you are safe, just run away. Don't wait, start taking photos or selfies to be a witness. Are we together? Again, don't start running towards the attacker and don't cooperate with the attacker. Sometimes they can tell you, boys and boys to this side, girls to this side. Don't cooperate. Run for your life. And in case you want to take cover, don't take cover of cardboards. Eh? You know cardboards are short, can go through. So go maybe on a wall.
We call this the main university library. And I'm going to take you through the online catalog. This area, we call it the OPAC area. That is online public access catalog. And if I can just define for you what is a catalog briefly, catalog is a list of all the materials that we have in this library. We have about 120,000 volumes of books, which we have already arranged in the library in various areas, as you'll be taken round to the shelves. And we have adopted a system of organizing all those resources, especially the print materials. We have organized them in a form of that list, which we call a catalog. And in this catalog, we have now come up with an online system, which we call POHA, whereby you can be able now to search the data that you want in that catalog. In this catalog, I'm going to talk about three main issues. Is how do you search the catalog? What are the main access points in this catalog? And also, how after you search the material that you wanted to search, what data do you get from this catalog? So that now it can connect you from the catalog to the shelf. So that you can now pick your book from the shelf and take it to the desk where you're supposed to be loaned that particular book.
This is a curation section where we segregate information materials you borrow from here and return books from to this desk. Are we together? And then we have just talked about the opening hours. You open the library from Monday to Friday, that is from morning 8 a.m. up to 10 in the evening. Are we together? Then on Saturdays, you open from 9 in the morning to 5 p.m. So those are the hours to use the library.
So in case you overstay the book for 10 days, shorten books. We charge them hourly. So what's up? In case you borrow a book today, time now is around 2:30. You are supposed to return it tomorrow at 2:30. Now we shall wait. You must charge 10 books a month. So we shall have 30 books. Are you together? So whenever you are borrowing any short material, you have to check on the time that you are borrowing. Because you use a system. So what's up? The system is fair. Sikuna masa. So be careful.
Architecture, they are the same. And the letter A stands for architecture and finance. The arrangement is the same. We start by arranging reference materials for architecture. And this first cell, this is where we sell reference material for architecture. You get me right? The arrangement is the same from N, N, A, N, B, F to N, Z. And numerically from 1 to 1,000.
My name is Richard Omolo Midigo. I'm the systems librarian in JK1 library. The library has two kinds of libraries in one. One is the physical library defined by the physical building itself. It contains print books and journals and any other print material. And we have a digital library that is composed of electronic resources. So these electronic resources are managed by a department or a section in the library called Digital Services, headed by Miriam Ndungu. The role of this particular section is to manage the access and also to maintain access to the same electronic resources. The library has a website where the links to those particular resources have been posted under the main link called electronic resources. The library has basically two kinds of resources, electronic books and electronic journals. These resources are accessible 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 7 days a week, and 30 days a month, and even throughout the year without closure. So the benefits of electronic resources are many, but I can mention just two. One of them being 24-hour access, the second one being multi-user access, meaning that one single page or one single resource or book or journal can be accessed by several users all at the same time without any of them interfering with the other. Then I'm here also talking about the access to these resources. The access is provided in two kinds of modes. One is password-based, another one is network-based. The password-based, the user has to have a password. The network-based, the user has to be connected to a particular network registered by the publisher. If you are not in that network, it means you cannot access the resource. But the university has provided, subscribed to a software, proxy software, which allows the users to access same resources which are network locked outside the university formal networks. So if you access this particular link, which we are calling off-campus access to e-resources, and you log into it, you are able to access the resources as if you are in the same physical location as the main campus of the university. Now, I go on to talk about information system section, which is headed by me, Richard Obono. This section manages the information systems or computer systems that are used to provide service in the library. We have a number of systems. One of them to start with is a borrowing system that is called COHA, Integrated Library Integrated Management System. This system manages the patron's details. It is able to provide charging and discharging services. It is able also to calculate fines for the users who overstay with books. We manage acquisition of library books and other resources through the same system.
T1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So normally we use 6 dots, but at one time you'll find one of the dots is not used. So when you use the 6 dots or the 6 keys, that one cancels the paperwork. But once you skip one and press the others, you make a sign, which a person who is blind is able to interpret what that means. it okay? So that is what I can see about brain. We also have a laptop for them. Those who are functioning or blind use a laptop. It's just the same way. Just it's called a slate and a sailor. So we use this slate to put the embossing paper inside here. Then we use this. It's a tool for you to make now the dots themselves now. So you can use it anywhere. It's portable. The parking trailer you cannot move. It's not portable. Is it okay? So that is what I can say. But apart from that, we also have those who are on wheelchairs. That is, who cannot move. Their movement is restricted. So we also give access to those people. Once they come to the library, they will not be able to reach out to the books on the shelves. So they come here, they give us what they need, and we go search the materials for them and give them for them to use.
Once again, let me take this opportunity to welcome you to the library. And as you have been told, in the library we have various sections. One of the sections is binary section. In binary section is where we undertake all binary services requirements. We have various types of binding as you can see. We have hardcover binding. Hardcover look like this. This hardcover binding we charge 300 shillings. We have also spiral binding like this, and for spiral binding we charge 100 regardless the size of the book. And also we have paper bag binding, and this is like this, and this one we charge 15 shillings.
I'll be talking about the one I'm responsible for, which is the Institutional Repository, which manages the special collection produced by JQuat for JQuat and above JQuat. The repository is hosted on the library website. When you get to the library website, you will find it on the right-hand corner. You click on it, it sends you to the repository, gives you a list of communities. It is divided in communities, and in each community are collections. Let me look at the journals community. In each community are collections, and within the collections is where we upload the resources.
My name is Solomon Maleche, head of processing section in the JQuat library. The main objective of function of acquisition section is to facilitate acquisition of information material, both print and hard copy, for both JQuat main library and its campuses. Among other tasks of this section include sourcing of information materials, processing of the same information material, meaning accessioning, stamping, barcoding, among others. The section also sources for gifts and donations, and we also do replacement of lost books or damaged books by library users. The section also does reprocessing of repaired books, those that come from binder section after they have been repaired. The other service of this section is to oversee the management of stationery and also cleaning material for the library.
My name is Jace, and I work in the reference section. In the reference section, we deal with past papers and pieces and magazines. For past papers, we are required to go to the library website, which you can Google JQuat Library. Once you are there, you activate, you'll see on the left-hand side, there is a drop. You activate your student account. Once you activate, you can be able to go to the student's portal. And to log in, you use your JQuat, the one you have activated, your JQuat email, and the password is your registration number. And the papers are arranged according to the colleges or the faculties. For example, if you are in the College of Human Resource, you can access your papers. If you are in the School of Architecture, you can access your papers from there. You only need to go to the search bar and search for the paper you want, either by title or code. And for the periodicals, we have both e and we have physical. We also have the undergraduate thesis. We have a small collection which you can come and access from the reference office. The reference office is also in charge of answering queries. In case of any query like, where do I get this book, or how do I use the catalog, or where is the washroom? For more information, you can just walk into the reference office. Thank you.
My name is Miriam Duwu. I work in a section called Digital Services Section. And I'm just going to give you a brief of exactly the kind of services that are offered here. One of the main ones is facilitating access to electronic books and journals. And when I talk about electronic books and journals, these are books and journals that are found online. Now, what JQuad has done, we have subscribed and some of them purchased electronic books and journals that cover all the courses taught here. For journals, we have a total of 38 databases of journals, and each of these databases has thousands and thousands of journal titles. We also have electronic books, and for electronic books, there are four major ones that we have access to. One of them is called Springer. Another one is called Ibrahim, a very popular database with undergraduate students. We have Taylor and Francis, and we also have Science Direct. Now, for you to get to have a complete listing of all these journals and books, we normally suggest a list of them to everyone on JQuad Mail on a regular basis. And whenever we have an addition, we also inform you of the same through your JQuad student email or staff email. Now, these journals and book and electronic books are found through the library website. And just to give you a glance of the website, this is how it looks like. And we have divided the journals and books. We have put them separately. So when you go to electronic books, you get a listing of all the electronic books that we have. If you want journals, you go to the journals and you have access to all that we have access to. So, like for example, if I go to books, these are the books that we have access to. And for you to get to the database of electronic books, you just click on any of them and you have access to them. Let me also mention that these are available both on the university network and outside the network. So what happens if you are outside the network? If you are outside the network, we have a link that we call off-campus access to e-resources. This is a very good link because it is what has made all our resources accessible to all our students, regardless of the location, meaning that none of our student or staff has an advantage over another. You can access these resources through this link from whatever location you are at. Now, what do you require for you to access on your off-campus? What you require is your student email and your registration number, and you'll be able to log in. If you're a member of staff, what you're supposed to do is you write an email to ICT Directorate, then they provide you with a username and password, and you're good to go. So that is a way you access when you're off campus. When you're within the campus, it is not complicated, because as long as you're on the library website and you click on any of the links, then you have access to the resources that are available for you. Now, in addition to facilitating access to e-resources, this section is mandated with managing the library website. And under management of the library website, some of the things that we do is update you on any news and events. Anything new happening in the library, we update you on that. Any new resource that has been added to the library, we update you on that, again through the library website. So it is advisable that you keep visiting the website so that you are more informed about any new service or resource that we add to the library. Now, in addition to managing the library website, we also manage the library social media networks. We have a library Facebook wall and a Twitter account, again geared towards keeping you informed. We try and keep the library Facebook wall as interesting as possible, and we normally encourage both students and staff to like it. And once you like it, as long as you're on it, then if we update you on anything, then we're alerted that there's some new information, and in that way you're also kept up to date. So those are the major services offered here. But I must add that in addition to this, we have noted that both our students and our staff need to be trained on how to use these resources. Therefore, we organize training for both members of staff and students. For students, we normally encourage that you talk to your chairman of department or your principal of the college, or if it's a school, the dean of your school, who are required to communicate with the university librarian, do a formal request, and from there we set a date and we organize on the training. The training is very important because you may know about these resources, but without the necessary skills to be able to access the information, then you will not be able to make the best use out of the resources. So those are the major services that we offer, but I encourage you to visit our website, and it will give you an idea of all the services that are offered in the library and also in this section in particular. Thank you for listening. We welcome you to be paying us a visit. If you have any inquiries, kindly feel free to do so through either the JQuad email, through our social media network, or any other channel that is available to you. Thank you so much and welcome. There is a longing only you can feel. A raging tempest only you can still. My soul is thirsty, Lord, to know you as I know. Drink from the river that flows before your throne. Take me deeper, deeper in love with you. Jesus, hold me close in your embrace. Take me deeper than I've ever been before. I just want to love you more and more. How I long to be deeper in love. Sunrise to sunrise, I will see your face. Drawn by the Spirit to the promise of your grace. My heart has found in you a hope that will abide. Here in your presence, forever satisfied. Take me deeper, love with you. Jesus, hold me close in your embrace.
Jesus, hold me close in your embrace. Take me deeper, deeper than I've ever been before. I just wanna love you more and more. How I long to be deeper in love. Oh yeah. How I